Hey, hey, guys, you're back at Clever TV. I'm Dana Ward with Joslyn Davis.
Hey, guys.
And can you believe it? We have Yani Gellman in the studio. It's OGR.
That's what we call your character,
OGR.
Yeah, that's what we call you.
Officer Garretty Reynolds.
I haven't heard that before.
Goodness.
That's pretty cool. I have my own acronym.
What do you call your PLL character?
Usually just Garrett, you know. People call me Officer Garrett, Officer Reynolds, but I like just Garrett, you know.
Well, it's so fun to meet you. We've already told you, we are diehard fans of the show, as is our audience. And your character is, I mean, pretty creepy.
Yeah.
Right? You're a nice guy, though. Like, you're very different from your character.
Yeah, you know, I like to think of him not quite, you know, as creepy, but more just sort of misunderstood, you know?
You probably know more than we do, right?
Totally.
Yeah, I mean, you know, that's the thing about my character is he does sort of like to sort of, you know, watch everything going on and keep tabs on everybody as it's happening. So that comes off as kind of creepy, but really he's just trying to protect the little town of Rosewood.
I'm happy that we all finally publicly know the creepy side of Officer Garrett, because you got arrested at the end of this season.
Right, but now the question is, did I actually do it? Was I framed? Was I set up? Am I actually guilty? Or so, you know, we'll have to see about that.
Well, Marlene King said that you're definitely in the picture, you're coming back, so that kind of makes me feel like you're either breaking out of jail or you're released or something.
Well, I think there's definitely a lot more to Garrett than what we've seen so far, you know, and I'm going to have my day in court. My character's going to get a chance to tell his side of the story, and we'll see where that leads.
Well, yeah, because when you think back on a lot of the characters that, like, as you said, were misunderstood, even Toby, when he first came onto the show, wasn't this great boyfriend of the year character. So
that's right.
What do you hope to see happen with Officer Garrett Reynolds? Do you think he'll still be OGR or he'll just be Garrett? No more officer in his future?
Well, I'm not, you know, I think it's going to be tough for him to go, you know, if he gets out of jail, getting back in the police force might be a bit of a stretch. So I think for a while, you know, you might see me more civilian clothes and might get a chance just to be Garrett for a while, which will be nice. But, you know, I think my character has his side of the story to tell. And I think, you know, whoever put him in jail is going to have some answering to do for that.
Oh my goodness.
I know we kind of want to take it back to the high school days before the show started airing, before we knew you and your accomplices, perhaps. The NAT club.
Right. The NAT club.
Can you please break
Nos
that down?
Nos anima divertis totis.
Well, I'm certainly glad you didn't ask me to pronounce that, because
I don't think that was right, though.
Well, we just call it the NAT Club for short, because, I think, you know, it's kind of shrouded in a little mystery, and I think we're going to find out more about it as season 3 goes on, because everything that happens in Rosewood nowadays is sort of, like, set up in the past. You know, all these things happened when we were all in school together, and you're seeing it all kind of unfold from there. So, you know, you'll definitely find out a lot more about the NAT Club going forward.
So is it wrong to assume that the NAT or NAT Club is affiliated with the A Club?
Or the
A-Team,
as we call it.
Because the A-Team that Mona was kind of hinting at with Spencer in that last scene.
See, part of the NAT Club is that you don't talk about the NAT Club.
Oh.
It wouldn't be the NAT Club if I was out here betraying my NAT Club friends.
True. Loyalty is key.
But that really is the question, you know, to what extent is the NAT Club, you know, involved with the A team, as you called it, not me. You know, you'll have to tune in for the next season to see how that's connected.
Now, someone that we do know, more than one person we do know that Garrett has been involved with, Jenna, whole relationship, and then now this Melissa relationship.
What?
Did you see that coming?
Like, you know, I was.
Were you surprised? Because we were.
I wasn't. No, I wasn't really surprised. I knew that, you know, as Officer Garrett, OGR is as you call me. You know, he has his sort of hand in a lot of different pots, so to speak. You know, he's on all sorts of different sides of the fence as a cop and as a friend to the Pretty Little Liars and so on. So it didn't surprise me that he was also hooking up with someone else on the show. But we're gonna see how that relationship unfolds going forward. You know, I think that was just sort of a bit of a teaser And there'll be more about that coming up.
Yeah, we're very excited about season three.
Oh, completely. Because the show is so secretive and there's a lot of mysteries unfolding, I like to know from all of the actors on the show, how do you keep track of all the secrets and how do you keep track of where you're at? Because I feel like sometimes as a viewer, we have to think back like, oh, this happened, so that cannot be, but this can be. How do you do it?
Well, we have a team of writers on set, you know, and producers who we can always go up to and ask, like, what is going on in this scene? Why am I doing this? Or how did this all come together? But we're also big fans of the show, just like you guys, so we're watching it just as much as you guys are, and that's one way we keep, you know, tabs on everything, you know, DVR like crazy. But we also talk to, like, the fans and stuff, and they tell us their crazy theories and what they think's going on and stuff, and then, you know, that's how we sort of keep linked in.
What's the craziest fan experience you've had so far? Because I imagine you've had some.
I mean, it kind of oscillates between, like, I can walk through a crowd without anyone sort of recognizing me at all, to, like, sometimes, like, I'll just see, like, you know, a big group of girls or whatever that it's just like, oh, shoot, my cover's blown and, you know, I have to do a whole bunch of pictures or whatever. But I really love meeting fans of the show because they really enjoy it so much and, you know, it's just cool for me to meet people who enjoy it as much as I do, you know. So, yeah.
And here you are back at work. Season three
we
started,
yesterday. Yep.
Yesterday. And you've already read through the first two episodes.
Yeah.
So what can fans look forward to?
You can look forward to seeing me in my prison garb or whatever you call that.
Orange is the color.
Orange is the color, yeah. I hope that's not too big a spoiler. so orange is going to be huge for summer.
Huge.
And yeah, you get to see for my character, you get to see me behind bars and you get to see me basically trying to get out of jail.
Do you think Allie is alive? Because I've been seeing a lot of tweets about this from, like, fan sites, and then we discuss it all the time, as do our entire team here. Do you want her to be alive? I kind of do.
I don't know, you know? I mean, I'm just as curious as you guys are as to, you know, if she's alive or not. I don't know. Have we actually ever seen a body of hers?
I haven't.
I haven't either, so. Until that sort of shows up. I mean, something.
What was pulled out, like, season one?
Supposedly her body,
right.
But like you said,
we didn't see it.
Yeah.
I don't really want to see it.
Yeah, well, until you actually see it, you'll
it's
never
Rosewood,
really know.
People.
Yeah.
Anything is possible.
I just love, Sasha plays the role, so.
Yeah.
You know, I hope she's alive just because I love working with that actress, you know, but. Who knows? You know, we'll have to wait and see.
On that note, you know, we've chatted with most of the cast. We love them all on the show and off the show. What can you tell us about, like, behind the scenes, what it's like shooting with such a great team?
You know, everyone just sort of, by this point, because we're going into our third season, we know each other really well, and we can kind of just, like, jump into a scene, and people know their relationships and their characters and so on. It happens very quickly, you know. But everything is so sort of like on set, so sort of hush hush and secretive and tense and, you know, mysterious. And then as soon as they yell cut, like, we're all sort of like goofing off and sort of just like being, you know, really fun and playing around, you know, to offset it. So it can be kind of funny sometimes in like the most intense scenes where someone's about to die or whatever else. And then afterwards, someone makes some like fart joke or something like that, you know, and just to cut the tension kind of thing.
Yeah. Is there anything fun or interesting on the set that maybe fans out there would be really curious to know?
Like what?
Like
craft service sushi every day. I don't know.
Or that the shed that everyone talks about, where it's at, or I mean anything.
I mean, insider. One of the cool things is that a lot of other shows shoot on the same lot that where we shoot on.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, one day you'll come to work and like Conan will be walking past you or, you know, we share some sets with True Blood, you know, and a lot of us are big fans of that show. So that's kind of cool to see those sets. So that, you know, that's kind of makes it exciting for me. You know, every day you come to work, you're not really sure what exactly to expect, you know, but you're kind of on this sort of like wild ride and you know, anything can happen over the course of the day. So it's just as much fun for us shooting it as it would be for you guys to watch it, you know?
good to hear.
Very cool. Well, thank you so much for stopping by, Yani. Hey,
thank you for having me.
OGR.
Lovely to meet you. OGR.
OGR. I like it.
OGR is in the house. So exciting. Thanks, you guys, for checking out Clever TV. Make sure you keep it here for more details all about Pretty Little Liars. You know we've got you hooked up. I'm Dana Ward with Joslyn Davis. We'll see you guys soon.
Bye, guys.